Hey guys, welcome to our movie recap channel. Today we will be watching the movie That's My Boy. So, please turn on the subtitles and spoilers ahead. The movie starts in 1984 at a school. We see Donnie, a teenager who is quite popular in his school. His friends start talking to him about girls. But Donnie seems uninterested. He tells his friends that he is no longer interested in girls of his age. He wants real women. Then, we see the hot teacher of his school. Every guy in the school is attracted by her beauty. Her name is Mary. Donnie has 2 concert tickets. So, he asks Mary if she wants to join him. Mary tells him that she isn't his girlfriend, and asking teachers to go on a date is completely inappropriate. But Donnie doesn't stop flirting with her. So, Mary gives him a month's detention. In the detention room, Mary starts to seduce Donnie. She tells him that she was really aroused by him. Donnie doesn't know if all this is real. Then, Mary takes Donnie to her office, and their affair starts. Their affair goes on for quite a long time. They even start meeting outside the school. Then one day, there's a school program going on in the auditorium. Suddenly, the whole school starts to hear something. To answer their curiosity, they open the curtains and find Donnie and Mary together. The whole school gets in shock of what they had seen. Mary runs away in shame. But Donnie gets cheers from the whole school, and he even enjoys it. Mary is taken to court for having a sexual relationship with her student. At the court, people find out that Mary is actually pregnant with Donnie's child. Mary gets a 30 years jail sentence, but Donnie, on the other hand, becomes a celebrity for impregnating his teacher. Many news channels take his interview, and he gets invited to many shows, which earns him a lot of money. 28 years later, everything takes a turn in Donnie's life. Donnie has become an alcoholic, and he has spent all the money he earned from the fame he got from impregnating Mary. His friend tells him that he hasn't paid any taxes in years. He owed exactly $43,000 to the government. And if he doesn't pay it, he will go to jail. But Donnie has no money left. He only has $20 to his name. His friend suggests that he should bet that money on a fat guy who was going to run a marathon. The betting odds of that fat guy winning was 8,000 to 1. Donnie thinks he has nothing to lose and bets the money. His friend asks him if he can get the money from his son. But Donnie reveals that his son left him after he had turned 18. And since then, they haven't talked to each other. This is the son that came after Mary's pregnancy. He named him Han Solo. Now, we see Han Solo. But he has changed his name to Todd. He has a beautiful girlfriend named Jamie, and is soon going to get married to her. The news of his marriage is in the newspapers, and Donnie soon finds out about it. He gets surprised to see his son lose weight and change his name. He also finds out that his son is now rich. After he left Donnie, Todd has kept information about his parents a secret. So, he told the media that his parents died in an accident. Donnie is furious to find out about all this. Todd takes his girlfriend's parents to his boss's house. His boss was letting them stay there until the wedding. At the house, he also gets to meet Jamie's brother who is a soldier. His name is Chad, and he warns Todd about not hurting his sister. Meanwhile, Donnie goes to Vanilla Ice, who was his friend, to get help about the money. But Vanilla Ice doesn't want to help him, because Donnie had slept with his mother. So, Ice attacks Donnie. Later, he goes to a TV producer, and asks him for his help. But, the producer says that he cannot help him, and people no longer were interested in him. So, Donnie says that what if they interview him and Mary, who was soon going to get released from jail. The producer seems interested, but he wants more. He asks Donnie about his son, and Donnie replies that Todd was very successful and rich. Hearing this, the producer tells Donnie that if he brings his son and gets an interview with him and Mary together, then he will give him $50,000. Donnie thinks about the money and immediately goes to meet Todd. Donnie goes to his house, and gets to meet Jamie. He enters the house, and Todd is surprised to see him there. Todd gets nervous and introduces Donnie as his friend, and not a father. Todd starts to make things up to make it seem like Donnie is his friend. Donnie plays along with him, and makes up strange stories. And everyone believes him. Todd says that Donnie should leave, but everyone wants him to stay for the wedding, and Donnie gets to stay there. Later, Todd is mad at Donnie and asks him why he was there. Donnie doesn't tell him about the interview. So he lies that his mother was really sick and he needs to see her before the surgery. Todd doesn't believe him at all. They start to get into an argument. Donnie believes that he was a great father, but Todd says that Donnie was the worst parent in the world. Just then, Jamie calls Todd about the cocktail party. And Todd wants Donnie to wear a tie for the party, but Donnie says that it was not his thing. However, he agrees to do it after Todd says that he will give him $100. At the party, Donnie shows up wearing a tie, but he has no pants on. Jamie introduces Donnie to Todd's boss, and they get along quickly. Donnie impresses everyone at the party with his fake stories. And one of the guests recognizes him as the student that got his teacher pregnant. Todd's boss then also recognizes him and asks him about the son he had with his teacher. Donnie says that his son grew to be a very rude person, as he looks at Todd. Everyone at the party knew Donnie, but no one knew that Todd was his son. Todd's co-worker, who is also the best man for the wedding, says that since Donnie and Todd are close friends, he should no longer be the best man. He says that Donnie should be the best man at Todd's wedding. Todd says that it is not necessary, but Donnie quickly accepts the offer. After that, Donnie proposes to play a game of baseball. Everyone is excited at this idea, except for Todd. Everyone in the field seems great at the sport, even the grandma and a little kid. But Todd is not athletic. Donnie bats the ball towards Todd, who fails to catch it. Everyone thinks that Todd is a loser. That night, Jamie tells Todd about Donnie's book. Donnie had written a book with a message that he loved his son. Todd gets emotional after seeing this. He also wants to sleep with Jamie, but she doesn't want to ruin the dress. Next day, Jamie's friends take her to the bachelorette party. Donnie asks if Todd has a bachelor party or not. Todd's friend says he has arranged everything. But Donnie isn't too happy when he finds out the bachelor party included a spa treatment. He thinks this is the worst bachelor party. He tells everyone that they should go to a strip club. And they all follow him. All of them have a fun night at the strip club. Todd too seems to be having fun at his bachelor's party. Donnie sends everyone off to the house. And he keeps Todd with him, as he wants to spend more time with him. Donnie gives Todd the earring of his mother as a wedding gift. Todd seems happy, but he doesn't have a pierced ear. So, Donnie pierces his ear and puts the earring on Todd's ear. Donnie tells Todd that they should meet Uncle Vinny. And Todd is surprised to find out that Uncle Vinny was none other than Vanilla Ice himself. The three of them get wasted that night and make quite more friends. Todd is really happy and is enjoying the night very much. At the end of it, Todd says that he will go visit his mother in the jail. Donnie realizes that he shouldn't use his son for money. They spend a very special night together, and their bond seems to be growing. So, Donnie doesn't want to risk it for money. Donnie tells Todd that his mother was lying about being sick. So, he doesn't have to go visit her. The two of them hug and go to sleep. Donnie finds Todd's boss's mother in his room. And Todd goes on to make out with a mannequin. Next morning, Jamie finds that Todd had puked all over her dress. She says that there's something else on her dress. She tastes it and finds out that Todd tried to have sex with her dress. Donnie, hearing this, is proud of Todd. But Jamie demands that Todd fixes the dress before their wedding. So, Todd goes to get dry cleaning and calls Donnie to let him know that he was going to meet his mother. Donnie tries to stop him, but Todd says that he wants to meet his mother. Donnie hurries up to go to the jail before Todd, to not let him know about the interview, which was going to pay him $50,000. Donnie reaches the jail and finds Todd waiting to meet his mother. Donnie tells Todd that he shouldn't be wasting time before his wedding. But, Mary shows up. She is older, but she hasn't changed one bit. Mary is happy to see both Donnie and Todd. Todd too seems happy by seeing his mother after a long time. Donnie is mesmerized to see Mary, and they both get a little nasty through the phone. Todd is obviously disgusted by them. Just then, the TV producer comes to them with a camera and starts asking questions to Todd. He realizes that Donnie came back to his life to get this interview, so he could get some money. Todd gets angry and leaves Donnie. Donnie realizes that he made a mistake by coming back to Todd's life. He prepares to leave the house, but he overhears Jamie talking to Steve, Todd's boss. Jamie was saying that Todd will never find out. Donnie realizes that Jamie is cheating on Todd with his boss. At the wedding rehearsal, Donnie goes to Todd to tell him about everything. Todd doesn't want to listen to anything he says. But Donnie tells him about the affair between his boss and Jamie. Jamie comes forward and tells everyone that she was planning a surprise for Todd and didn't want him to find out. She says that Donnie heard the conversation and misjudged everything. Donnie realizes that he made a mistake, so he gets out of there. After the rehearsal, Jamie and her brother go together in a car, leaving their parents and Todd alone. Donnie watches Todd from afar and thinks about how he can make things right between them. His friend suggests that he should first apologize to Jamie. So, Donnie gets two ice creams and goes to apologize to Jamie. But outside a room, he hears Jamie having sex with someone. Todd was obviously left behind. So, who was she sleeping with? Donnie breaks into her room and catches Jamie cheating on Todd. And pretty soon, he sees that the man Jamie was sleeping with was none other than Chad, her brother. Seeing this, Donnie is shocked. He feels disgusted by the incestuous relationship between Jamie and Chad. He clicks a picture of them and says that he will tell everything to Todd. But Jamie offers him money. Jamie says that she will give him the money he needs if he shuts up and tells nothing to Todd. Donnie is desperate and he accepts the money. Next day, Donnie sits in his house ashamed of what he has done. But he realizes that he still has time before the wedding. So, he goes to Vanilla Ice and asks for his car. Vanilla Ice and Donnie ride together pretty roughly to crash Todd's wedding. At the wedding, the vows have been taken and Todd is going to accept the marriage. Donnie reaches the wedding just in time and stops everything. Todd is embarrassed to see Donnie ruin his wedding. Donny points at Jamie and says that he cannot allow his son to marry such a woman. Donny calls Todd his son in front of everyone. Jamie is disgusted to find out that Todd was the child of a sexual relationship between a teacher and a student. Donny calls her out for cheating on Todd. Jamie obviously refuses the accusation, but Donny shows everyone the check that Jamie had given to him to shut up about everything. Donny even tears the check to prove that his son was more important than the money. Jamie tells Todd about her sleeping with Chad and says that they should get married anyway because they both weren't perfect. But Todd is just disgusted to find out that Jamie was sleeping with her brother. He tells everyone at the wedding about the relationship between Chad and Jamie, and needless to say, everyone is disgusted as well. Chad blames everything on Jamie and leaves from there. Jamie apologizes to Todd and asks him to accept her. Todd looks at his dad and Vanilla Ice, who both are shaking their heads. Todd finally realizes his worth and says no to Jamie. He cancels the wedding and then proudly tells everyone that his dad was Donny. Todd then tells his boss that he is quitting the job. Vanilla Ice then tells Todd that his boss was also sleeping with Jamie. His boss tries to deny it, but Todd tells him that Vanilla Ice and Donny had slept with his mother, so he doesn't feel that bad. Todd then leaves the wedding with his father. Todd is now happy with Donny and says that he wants to pay the money to save him from going to jail. But Donny says that he should be responsible for his own actions and doesn't want money from his son. Just then, Donny's friend comes to them and turns on the TV. The fat guy that Donny bet $20 on was doing pretty good in the marathon. Donny seems to have a chance of winning the bet. The fat guy passes every runner in front of him and unexpectedly wins the race. And with that, Donny wins $160,000 from the $20 he bet. In the end, Donny doesn't have to go to jail. Everyone cheers and the movie ends. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel to never miss out on our videos.